15 creepy exorcism cases too believable to ignore. Part 2. If you are brand new to our channel, we invite you to take a moment to subscribe. Just click on the lit red button as well as the gray bell. Why the bell? Well, it will let you know every time we post a new video. 9. Marisica Irina Cornizzi. Here is another tale of an exorcism gone horribly wrong. Apparently, even Romanian exorcisms can be quite deadly. In 2005, a nun was crucified in an attempt to rid her soul of the demons, which were thought to torment her. Cornizzi, who was received as a guest at the Holy Trinity Convent in Romania, found herself plagued with hearing the devil's voice in her head. She claimed the voices were telling her that she was sinful, and visited the local hospital, where she was diagnosed as schizophrenic. Cornizzi was given medication and sent back to Holy Trinity. Case closed, right? Nope. Unfortunately, it was decided that Cornizzi was not schizophrenic, but actually possessed by Father Daniel and the other nuns upon her return to the convent. They claimed that she became intolerable following her return. She was violent and refused to drink holy water, so she had to be possessed, and it was the good father and nun's job to cast the demons from her. They bound the nun to a cross, gagged her with sheets, and left her to die of dehydration and asphyxiation. It's not likely that this possession will go down in history as creepy, but the exorcism was chilling enough. All five went to trial and were found guilty in causing Cornizzi's death. 10. George Lukens. In 1788, George Lukens, a British tailor, first mistook his possession for witchcraft, but he became famous when the cause of his problem was found to be demons. His possession began after he went out drinking with a friend. Upon waking up, Lukens found that he was not able to endure religious items and was subject to fits. In these fits he would leap around while shouting in odd voices, both male and female. Lukens eventually decided that he was possessed by seven devils, not witchcraft. It was somehow decided that Lukens would need seven exorcists to cast out his seven demons, but the clergymen of the Church of England would not agree. So he ended up with seven Wesleyan Methodists instead. The Protestant ministers are not allowed to carry out the rites of exorcism, but they were able to pray and call on the demons to depart, which they did after two long hours. George Lukens was fine afterwards and was able to lead a productive life. 11. Mother Teresa. It would be nice to believe that nuns, priests, and all church officials are safe from the demons that lurk in wait of an opportune victim. If those who are supposed to be holy are not safe, then what chance do the rest of us have? Sorry to disappoint, but even Mother Teresa was not safe when it came to demons. Apparently, she had a bout of insomnia while she was hospitalized a few months prior to her death. Lucky for her, an archbishop was also hospitalized just a few rooms down. Archbishop Henry Sowes was quick to rationalize that demons might be troubling her sleep after the doctor told him of Mother Teresa's troubles. Sowes asked the hospital priest permission to perform a prayer of protection on the disturbed nun. The exorcist felt that it was possible that Mother Teresa's sleep was troubled because the devil may have been trying to attack her. He claimed Mother Teresa appeared troubled at first sight, but that she seemed to be at peace following the prayer of protection. It was said that Mother Teresa slept fine afterwards. What? No projectile vomit. Now you know that some rituals are quite mild. 12. Julia. Julia was the pseudonym given to a young lady whose possession and exorcism was documented by psychiatrist Dr. Richard E. Gallagher. Julia began to show moderate symptoms of possession after being involved with numerous satanic cults. Her demons were not shy-natured either, as she would often levitate in front of priests, nuns, and psychiatrists. Julia also knew things which she could not have possibly known. private things that would go on with family members back home, like deaths, illnesses, and even arguments. Julia spoke several languages fluently, although the true Julia only knew English. She would also go into trance-like states and speak in a voice different from her own. Julia would say things like, "She's ours," and "Leave, you imbecile priest," according to documents written by Gallagher. When the rite of exorcism began, she remained quiet at first, but later started to projectile vomit and spout growling inhuman sounds from her mouth. Dr. Gallagher has not confirmed if or when Julia's exorcisms were concluded, or if she was ever cured, but she is not the first case to remain unsolved, or the last for that matter. 13. Janet Moses. In 2007, Janet Moses woke up in the night in fear of her life, and began threatening the lives of those around her. Her family believed that she and another relative had been possessed because of the theft of a concrete lion taken from a pub. The lion was returned to the pub, but things didn't improve. The family decided that an unsupervised exorcism was the answer. The ritual was carried out by 10 family members, none of which had any idea what they were. 14. Michael Taylor. Not all exorcisms have happy endings. This was the case with the exorcism of Michael Taylor, who killed his wife Christine Taylor in October of 1974. He was taken into police custody after he strangled her, gouged out her eyes with his fingers, and ripped part of her face off before ripping his mother's dog apart by the limbs. He was deemed mentally unstable after the members of his church backed his rather unusual story. They all claimed that he had just undergone an exorcism in which the majority of his 40 demons had been excised. The church performed the exorcism based on his growing obsession with the woman in charge of the study group at the church. His wife had called him out for cheating on her while they were at a sermon, but this caused him to attack the woman in question. When Michael's behavior consistently grew worse, the church decided that he was possessed. The exorcism consisted of spoons being forced down his throat, and he was doused with holy water. This went on until the group grew tired and sent the couple home until they could resume the exorcism the next day. None of this was documented until after he was charged with murdering his wife. Michael claimed that he didn't recall any of the ordeal, but did say that he was possessed by demons. Say, 15. Anna Etland. Emma Schmidt, aka Anna Etland, lived under the possession of several demons for over 20 years. The demons included her incestuous father, her aunt, and at least two others. She would hear voices, was extremely obsessive, and despite being very religious, she found herself struggling with an unexplained anger towards religious places and objects. Father Theophilus Reisinger carried out the rites of exorcism on Emma in a convent, with the permission of Bishop Thomas Drum. The rite was carried out three times over a three-week period. The events were recorded with the help of Vogel, who wrote that Emma's body flew through the air and lodged itself above a door. Emma had refused any food or drink that had been blessed, and her face would often become distorted. It was also documented that despite Emma's low food intake, she vomited green bile constantly. Emma was finally freed after several attempts, and screamed out "Praised be Jesus Christ" afterwards.